May I now request our special guest, Sri Damjung Imna Along, Honorable Minister of Higher and Technical Education and Tribal Affairs, Government of Nagaland, to kindly do the honor of unfurling of the Golden Jubilee flag, followed by which the school anthem. Humble and dedicated children, from 1969 to 2019, from merely 2 to 3 classes to a vast campus, from a drop of few students to an ocean of 1,369, from a faint whisper to a thunderous roar, Christ King Higher Secondary School has come a long way. It has been a pretty remarkable 50 years by any standards. Ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning and welcome to the 50 years Golden Jubilee of Christ King Higher Secondary School, Kohima.
A reading from the Book of Psalm, number 138, verses 1 to 2. I give you thanks, O Lord, with my whole heart. Before the gods, I sing your praise. I bow down toward your holy temple and give thanks to your name for your steadfast love and your faithfulness. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your unconditional love and faithfulness we have experienced in the past 50 years. Lord, we celebrate your goodness and blessings which have brought us to this day. As we thank you, we implore your blessings upon all of us gathered here this morning to celebrate the Golden Jubilee. May we continue to praise your holy name through our good deeds and lives. We make this prayer in your name. Amen.
Thank you, sister, for invoking God's blessings. May I request you, sister, to also read the apostolic blessings of Holy Father Pope Francis to Christ King staff and students on this great occasion.
The Holy Father Francis cordially imparts the requested apostolic blessing to Father Lunio Linus STB, the principal, staff and students of Christ King Higher Secondary School, Kohima, on the occasion of the 50th anniversary of the foundation of the school. Invoking through the intercession of the Virgin Mary an abundance of divine graces. Christ King Church, Kohima Village, Nagaland, 10th October 2019.
Light brings a ray of hope, happiness and glow. To mark the 50 years, we shall now have lighting of 50 golden candles. And to do this, I take the pleasure of inviting Sister M. Joy, Provincial Superior of Bethany Sisters, to light the main candle and the rest led by Mr. Nilovuli Edran, alumni president, signifying the 50 brilliant years of the function. Let the rays of light reach far and wide. Like this light, Kriskin Higher Secondary School will shine on and on and tirelessly endeavor with honesty to fulfill its mission. Thank you, Christ King Jubilee Choir, for your delightful presentation.
Today, 10th October 2019, is an auspicious day in the annals of Christ King Higher Secondary School. Today, we celebrate its golden jubilee, 50 years of its existence, existence for education of the society, education for transformation of the self, education to uplift the society, education to knowledge, education for service, education for leadership. Like Saint John Bosco, whom children lovingly call Don Bosco, we can say Christ King Higher Secondary School was for the students a home that welcomed a parish, a home that welcomed, a parish that evangelized, a school that prepared them for life, and a playground where friends could meet and enjoy themselves. As we celebrate the Golden Jubilee of Christ King Higher Secondary School, I heartily welcome our special guest, Sri Themjan Imna Long, Honorable Minister, Higher and Technical Education and Tribal Affairs, Government of Nagaland. We are immensely grateful to you, sir, for making it a possibility to come and be the special guest of the day. Your presence has made this program meaningful for all of us. Most Reverend Bishop James Topil, Bishop of Kohima, Nagaland, your presence is a blessing for all of us. As spiritual head of the Catholic Church of the Diocese of Kohima, your presence means a lot to us. Your presence is a blessing for us. We are greatly honored to have Father Nazarus Lakra, Vice Provincial of the Salesian Province of Dimapur. Thank you for your presence and encouragement. Dear Sister Joy, Provincial of the Bethany Sisters, and Sister Sandy, Vice Provincial, thanks for your availability and your presence here today. I would like to acknowledge the presence of all the people gathered here today, especially in a very special way, the Christ King Higher Secondary School Alumni President, Mr. Niluvolia Adrian Messelo, and his friends, executives, and all other alumni members. You have studied here, you have passed through this institution, and you're most welcome here to once again reminiscence your past days in this Christ King Higher Secondary School. We acknowledge the presence of the principals, the parish priests who worked here earlier and who have come here today to make this day a special place. We acknowledge the presence of principals and heads of different schools in and around Kohima. Mr. President, Catholic Union, Keningu Albert, Catholic Union, Christ King Church Kohima, the chairman of Peak Hill, the village Gaumburas, our authority members here, the various landowners, the chairman Usuma Clan, the president, Kohima Village Youth Organization, the president, Kohima Village Students Union, the presidents of Peak Hill Youth and presidents of Peak Hill Youth and Students Union, Kohima Village, friends in the media and press, our parents, teachers, the students, all present here, and all the well-wishers of Christ King. This is your day to remember with gratitude to God for all the blessings that He has given us in these past 50 years. Every batch would take pride in saying, in our time, we did this, we did that, we were the naughtiest. Sure, those beautiful past days blended with studies, those were the lively and interesting days. They were naughty actions, but not wicked. That's fun. And we wish all of you a wonderful day today. And as we welcome all of you for this day's program, we also would like to acknowledge the great works done by the past principals who are no more with us today. We would like to gratefully remember Father Michael, Father Devasia, Father PM Joseph, and Father Salu Thomas, and Sister Loyola, Sister Lucy Manuni, and Sister Berlinda. We believe that they are showering their blessings upon us, all of us, today. Once again, welcome to every one of you, and have a wonderful day.
Good morning and welcome, ladies and gentlemen, and my dear students. I am Mr. Jalukonyo Kotu. First of all, I thank the Almighty God for this auspicious day. I congratulate the governing body, the principal, the staff, and the students of Christ King Higher Secondary School, Kohima, on the celebration of its Golden Jubilee 2019. Jubilees are occasions to be celebrated to recall the marvelous ways in which the school has fulfilled its mission in imparting education, moral and spiritual values, and discipline to build leaders who will bring about a culture of peace and love which our society needs today. I am extremely thrilled, honored, and excited to introduce our guests and invitees and do the presentation this morning. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome and introduce our special guest, Sri Temjan Imna Along, Honorable Minister, Higher and Technical Education and Tribal Affairs, Government of Nagaland. I thank you so very much, sir, for kindly agreeing to grace this occasion with your presence. We are indeed happy to have you in our midst. We have nothing special to give you, yet, as a sign of our love and appreciation, we would like to present a small token. So, I request you to kindly rise up and receive it. Sri Temjan Imna Along, Honorable Minister, Higher and Technical Education, Tribal Affairs, Government of Nagaland. Thank you, sir. I am also pleased to introduce our guest of honor, Right Reverend Dr. James Topil D.D., Bishop of Kohima Diocese, and Reverend Father Nazareth Lagra, SDB, Vice Provincial Salesian Province of Dimapur. May I request you, dear fathers, to kindly stand and receive a token. Reverend Father Nazareth Lagra, SDB, Vice Provincial Salesian Province of Dimapur. Mr. Wangye Konyak, 1992 batch, and Ms. Lydia Yapto, 1993 batch, who will be presenting Reminiscing the Golden Past. Dear sir and miss, kindly do stand and receive a token. Ms. Lydia Yapto, 1993 batch. Mr. Wangye Konyak, 1992 batch. Bethany Sisters, Vice Provincial, to kindly rise up and receive a token. Sister Joy Provincial, BS, and Sister Sandhya, BS. Thank you. I am delighted to introduce to you the Christ King Higher Secondary School Alumni President, Mr. Nilufolie Adrian Mechalo, a patient, hardworking, and understanding person whose leadership quality is just admirable. Dear sir, kindly do stand and receive a small token of our appreciation. Thank you, sir. I also take this opportunity to acknowledge the most cool, helpful, and untiring people in our family of Christ King Higher Secondary School. So I request Father Leonor Linus, the present principal, Sister Melissa Darlong, our headmistress, Father Paul Bonner, our rector, and Father Thomas to kindly stand and receive a small token. Father Lionel Linus, the present principal, Sister Melissa Darlong, our headmistress, Father Paul Puna, our rector, and Father Thomas. Dear fathers and sisters, without your constant support, patience, and love towards the school, we would be nowhere today. Thank you. Taking our presentation further, we now have a dazzling array of invitees and guests from the neighboring schools. We would like to acknowledge you with a memento, and as I mentioned your school name, kindly do stand and receive it. Principal, Don Bosco Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, Don Bosco College, Kohima. Principal, Don Bosco College, Kohima. Principal, KD Baptist Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, Baptist High, Kohima. Principal, Nilozu Government Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, TM Government Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, Mount Sinai Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, Holy Family Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, Model Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, St. Mary's Cathedral Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, Little Flower Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, St. Joseph Higher Secondary School, Visuema. Head Teacher, St. Luke School, Pezucha. Head Teacher, Holy Cross School, Chedema. Head Teacher, St. Stephen School, Resoma. Head Teacher, Government Middle School, PKL. Head Teacher, Government Middle School, TKL. Head Teacher, Government Middle School, LKL. And Head Teacher, Government Middle School, DKL. I repeat again. Principal, Don Bosco Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, Don Bosco College, Kohima. Principal, Kerry Baptist Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, Baptist High, Kohima. Principal, Niluzu Government Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, TM Government Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, Mount Sinai Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, Holy Family Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, Model Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, St. Mary's Cathedral Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, Little Flower Higher Secondary School, Kohima. Principal, St. Joseph Higher Secondary School, Kohima, Visuema. Head Teacher, St. Luke School, Pezucha. Head Teacher, Holy Cross School, Chedema. Head Teacher, Government Middle School, PKL. Head Teacher, St. Stephen School, Resoma. Head Teacher, Government Middle School, DKL. Head Teacher, Government Middle School, LKL. And Head Teacher, Government Middle School, DKL. Thank you. We are also pleased to have in our mix some people who have come from all walks of life to grace our occasion this morning. We are grateful for your very presence and would like to acknowledge you with a memento. First of all, we have Chairman Kohima Village Council. We are also pleased to have in our mix some people who have come from all walks of life to grace our occasion this morning. We are grateful for your very presence and would like to acknowledge you with a memento. Chairman, Chairman, Kohima Village Council. Chairman, Kohima Village Council. Please stand wherever you are and receive it. President, Kohima Village Youth Organization. President, Kohima Village Students Union. President, PKL Council, Kohima Village, kindly do stand in your place and receive it. President, PKL Students Union Kohima Village. President, PKL Youth Organization. President, Catholic Union Christkind Church. President, Catholic Women Association Christkind Church. President, Catholic Youth Association Christkind Church. President, Catholic Tefako Koto Christkind Church. President, Gehui Mepha Metsu Koto Kohima Village. President, Kohima Village Gazetted Officers Association. President, Kehuimie Zavifoko Kroto Kohima Village. Kitikis, Christkind Church Kohima Village. Kitikis, Christkind Church Kohima Village. Turin Kitikis, Christkind Church Kohima Village. Rector, St. Paul Parish, Pesama Village. Rector, Loyola, Jacama Village. St. Joseph College, Fathers, Jacama Village. AC Sisters, Loyola, Jacama Village. FCC Sisters, Pesama Village. Ave Maria Convent Sisters, Jacama Village. Carmel Convent, Jacama Village. Adoration Convent, Jacama Village. And Sister Benny Sylvia. Sister Benny Sylvia. Moving on, if your actions inspire others to dream more, learn more, do more, and become more, you are a leader, said John Quincy Adams. It's our privilege to have some inspiring personalities with us today, and it would be a shame on our part if we fail to introduce and acknowledge them. Dear friends, as I call out your names, please do stand and receive a token. First of all, Reverend Father Nisalu Carlos, Vicar General, Kohima Diocese. Gregory Tejawelia Sote, DC, Kohima. At your measure, Nagaland State Chief Commissioner, Nagaland Bharat Scouts and Guides. Chairman, Nagaland State Social Welfare Board, Government of Nagaland. Secretary, Nagaland State Social Welfare Board, Government of Nagaland. Coordinator, Nagaland Adolescent Girls Club. Christkind Higher Secondary School Golden Jubilee Anthem Composers, Mr. Nico Kejie and Mr. Imsujang Tadir. Christkind Higher Secondary School Choir Master, Miss Medotinho Pore. Words alone cannot express our feelings of gratitude to all the alumni members, without whose constant help, physically, spiritually, and financially, our Jubilee would not have been a good one. Although we have nothing special to give you in return, our earnest prayer is, may God bless you abundantly for your big hearts and hard work. We would like to acknowledge some of its members with a memento. Kindly do stand wherever you are and receive it. Mr. Nidilhu Kedichu, Mr. Kevidezo Peter, Mr. Kevidezo Peter, Mr. Nikihetyo Sote, Mr. Zedi Kolye Kire, Dr. Esther Procha, Dr. Teyeprezo Solo, Mrs. Alem Jungla Ayer, Miss Robotenior Root, Miss Mezovonio, and DGP Van. We also would like to acknowledge the conveners of different committees of the alumni with a memento. Dear friends, as I call your names, kindly stand wherever you are and receive it. Medojat Yoruta, Finance Committee Convener. Vimhalie Piena, Convener, Monolith Committee. Vizokonyo Irene Hyome, Convener, Reception Committee. Miss Rita Crocha, Convener, Souvenir Committee. Mr. Narayan Bahadur, Convener, Press and Media. Dr. Vilato Felix Ruta, Convener, Program Committee. Mr. Nilabityo Ruta, Convener, Sitting and Venue Arrangement Committee. Miss Mary Sekose, Convener, Stage and Decoration Committee. Mr. Vikepelu Ruta, Convener, Water and Sanitation. Madam Kikrusenyo Chelye, Convener, Power and Electricity. Mr. Kiridelye Kire, Convener, Sound System. Mr. Nijengulye Rame, Convener, Food and Refreshment Committee. Last but not the least, we now have the past principals, headmistresses, and rectors of Christkind Higher Secondary School. We would like to acknowledge them with a traditional muffler and a memento for rendering their selfless service to the school in the past. They are Reverend Father P.K. Matthew, Reverend Father P.X. Andrew, Reverend Father Jerome Moshari, Reverend Father Peter Salu, Reverend Father A.J. Sebastian, Reverend Father C.J. Sebastian, Reverend Father Elo Samuel, Reverend Father T.C. Joseph, Reverend Father C.J. Matthew, Reverend Father Joshua Gunmai, Reverend Father Deli David, Sister Teresa Monica, Bethany Sister, and Sister Margaret, Bethany Sister. I now request Mr. Keningu Albert Ruta, the President, Catholic Union, Christkind Church, to kindly come over to the stage and take the time. Thank you. Long live CKHSS.
Honorable Special Guest Yuritim Jim Imna, along Honorable Minister of High and Technical Education and Tribal Affairs Government of Nagaland, our guest of honor, Right Reverend Dr. James Topil, D.D. Bishop of Kohima, Nagaland, Reverend Father Nazarius Lakhtra, S.D.B. Vice Provincial Salesian Province of Dimapur, Father Paul Puna, the Parish Priest and Rector of Christkind Parish, Father Linus, the Principal of Christkind Higher Secondary School, Sister Melissa, the Vice Principal, all the dignitaries present here, fathers, sisters, the President Alumni Association of Christkind Higher Secondary School and its members, all the teachers, parents, well-wishers, and the students. On the occasion of celebrating the Golden Jubilee of Christ King Higher Secondary School, Kohima, the school and the church would be like to acknowledge the land donors, those persons who are kind enough and have a vision for the future generation and are kind enough to come forward to donate their land for the starting of the school and the community here. So on the occasion of the Golden Jubilee of Christ King Higher Secondary School, we cannot forget the people of Pikel Kohima Village who made it possible to establish the school in 1969 and for its development and expansion in the following years. There have been visionaries who have taught for the education and welfare of their sons and daughters. Now we are the beneficiaries of their generosity, their big hearts in parting with their lands by way of donation, selling, or exchange of land was for a greater cause of development of education of the future generation. Today, we would like to show our appreciation to these magnanimous people. But before we call out the names of the land donors, I would like to say a few words in Tenyidie to express our gratitude to them. Keho zano, moleseki zano. Nyego, shike lomye zivi lenino, nye ki zi krimo dino, ki zi kabye keho zise. Keho usi dino, leseki hao ha tsili. Hao tsiki ligino, ugo ninyo, ba hu shiri uki himi ninyo hao nino. Lesipre, masili hanano, uke preset delidi, ti shio dino. Mi mozono, mi tono, mi fugazzo pelide. Nugo, sigolimits of legazigino, mahu tsegasola, kehushiri, molasaki shiri, nugo pesio tortaway. Temeka cragizipile, mi petiki the city, lesaki suit, lesaki so hat sigazzo somo, there is lesaki war, sigatua, uff father mi bamorso, kehu bamorso, sigazola, lesaki tetsugro, yakehuki. Tetsukubie, Kehukitsa, Probobie, Lesakitsa, Probobie, Kabatami, Bagatsa, Probobie, Matoke, Gritsadi, Lesakila, Simorgeso, Matoke, Gregatsa, Sagatsu, Savoli, Sigatula, Nego, Makevitsagasigino, Tier, Lesaki, Titi, Hippenguni, Nigazano, Makatsubo, Pier, Nego, Tsagasso, Tsasana, Sigatulano, Nego. Krunyogo, Nyogo Futsanyogo Zakisaliro, Nyogo Uchu, Nyogo Uni Nyogo, Morigo Son of Work, Abago, Nyogo Pejiri Kordisu, Pilije, Gatsa City, Nyogo Pesisia. So now I request the sons, their grandchildren, or any of the representative of these landowners may kindly come forward and receive their present from. On behalf of, from our school. And now I request our rector and parish priest father, Popune, and our special guest, Suri Temjem Ina Alon, to come forward and give the present to the land owners. Mr. Vikosa Rame, Usuma Klen, Mrs. Sonia Rame, Usumaklen, Mrs. Sonia Rame, Mr. Pujili Pine. Mr. Kralitir Ruta, Zasilie Belo, Mr. Vimedor Ruta, next, Mr. Saluz Ruta, Mr. Saluz Ruta, next, Mr. Hevizole Pienne, Mr. Hevizole Pienne. Next, Mr. Zakivi Ruta. Next, Mr. Kuchar Rame. Next, Mr. Mezatu Opine, Zatu Opine. Next, Mr. Cruz Keyo. Duko Sote, Duko Sote. Next, Mr. Vinolier Mere. Vinolier Mere. Mr. Zashivilier Ruta. Next, Mr. Tsu Belo. Mr. Tsu Belo. Thank you, sir, and thank you, Father. Bokusa Nyeko. Sike lume ze lenino make vitsa ke sala nyugo ke pe jipu se yamo u ke pe nyevubu jabie nyugo tse presulie tine. The fathers, sisters, and the Catholic community at large are very grateful to these generous souls for cooperating with us to serve the society in general. Kraiskin Higher Secondary School will always stand to serve the people of Kohima in particular, and the people of Nagaland in general. Long live Kraiskin Higher Secondary School. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Tejalukunyo and Sir Albert, for introducing the guest and the presentation. We feel privileged to have all present here. Since its year of inception in 1969, Kraiskin Higher Secondary School has been growing from strength to strength, turning out batches of students, many of whom have strides in different walks of life across the globe. It is therefore with much euphoria and jubilation that we are going to release a souvenir for Golden Jubilee. And to do so, I request Miss Christina to come and take the time.
Thank you for the time. Kraiskin Higher Secondary School, in its 50 years of journey, is the labor and sacrifices of the pioneers, and this magazine are brought forth in communication of the dedicated service of the pioneers, principals, vice principals, teachers, and the passionate, zealous students from 1969 till date who have been part of the 50 years journey of the institution. In a particular way, I would like to express my appreciation to Ms. Rita Crocha, a prominent writer, publisher, freelancer journalist, for her professional touch in editing, designing, and for bringing out this beautiful souvenir. May I now request our honorable special guest, Sri Temjan Imna Along, to release the souvenir and hand over the first copy to Right Reverend Dr. James Topiel, DD Bishop of Kohima Diocese. Ladies and gentlemen, a huge round of applause as the souvenir has been released. May I also request our honorable special guest to hand over one copy to Reverend Father Nazarius Lakra, SDB Vice Provincial, Salishan Province of Dimapur. And one copy to Sister Joy, Provincial Superior Bethany Sister. One copy to Father Nisalu Carlos, Vicar General of Kohima Diocese. Mr. Tejawele Grigori, Deputy Commissioner of Kohima. Atto Major, Chief Commissioner, Nagaland State Bharat Scouts and Guides. And Mr. Niluvolye Adrain, Alumni President. Thank you, sir.
We thank our special guests and guest of honor for releasing the Golden Jubilee souvenir. We cannot listen to one voice above all others. We must listen to a choir of voices if we are to understand the individual tunes. We shall now hear the great Jubilee from the Christkind Higher Secondary School Jubilee Choir.
Time to heal the wounds of division.
Moments always blossom more beautifully in memories, and the best things in life are those memories that we made during our school days life. Here we have reminiscing the golden past from Mr. Wone Koniak of 1992 batch, followed by Ms. Lydia Yupto of 1993 batch. Kindly take your time respectively.
During our days at Christ King, we used to have a phrase which has become a legend among our batch mate and our 2-3 juniors. The phrase was, all those who have no sambut, put your hand up. I believe my batch mates will remember that. That is the memory phrase of our golden bus. Honorable special guest, Yuritamjan Imna Along, Honorable Minister, Higher Technical Education, Tribal Affairs, Guest of Honors, Bishop of Nagaland, Vice Provincial Salesians Provisions of Dimapur, the Rector and Parish Priest of Christ King Paris, the Principal, Vice Principal, teachers, students, and all the alumni, and all the parents who have gathered here, and the students of Christ King Higher Secondary School, I, on behalf of the Alumni Association, wish you a very glorious Golden Jubilee celebrations. I am privileged to take this time. Let me first not go to that memory lane, but first let me, first of all, thank the Alumni Association led by our young and energetic president, who is still, by the way, who is still bachelor. He is young and still energetic, and he is ready to mingle. Because of his hard work, because of his tireless effort, that we are having a beautiful Jubilee celebration. And also, not forgetting the executive and also the conveners of different committees. And also, S. Mary and Hoily, I remember you, because last night they told me to acknowledge them also. So that's why I'm acknowledging both of you. Please don't complain after the function that I have not acknowledged you. Thank you. And also, I take this opportunity this time to thank the principal and the staff of the Christ King Higher Secondary School for managing the whole entire show. Well, during our days, I remember the two persons that, in fact, my friends will agree to it, that two persons that we remember is Father B.K. Mathew and Miss Zita. I think Miss Zita is around here somewhere. She's still young and evergreen. And Father Mathew was like our own biological father. He, you know, knew all of us. I think we were around about, the entire school has around about 500 plus odd students. Right now, I just learned this morning that 1,000 plus we have students. Those days we had around about 500 plus students. And Father Mathew was a kind of a person who knew each and everyone's name. And that was really admirable. And especially, we remember his activities. He was a kind of a farmer who was sowing seed, you know, just spreading it out. We were made to, I don't know, even force, or what do we call it? But those days we call it forced. We were forced to participate in singing. We were forced to participate in solo competition, extempore speech kind of competitions. We were made to, you know, play different kind of sports activities. Above all, his most goal was education. We were made to get good marks. That was what he did. And that time we felt as if, like, you know, he is pushing us too much. But when we remember Now, when we recollect and think of it now, the past years that we have been in this school, this school has given us, because of that strictness, because of that, the activities that we were involved in, we have become what we are today. And we have, because of that only, we all of us, all our batchmates and my juniors, 2-3 badges, they all of them are what they are today because of that sickness. During the school days, we thought it was a forceful thing, but in fact, it was a real learning experience. It was, in fact, a real motivational strength set by the school. And Miss Zita, you really made your effort to make us sing, and I'm really thankful to you because today I'm a very good bathroom singer. I'm trying to be, entertain you all because our president, when he called me up, you know, I'm very lucky, I'm very lucky to come and speak in this Jubilee because I remember when we were students, people used to offer sweets, but out of courtesy, we say thanks. And then the sweet was not given to us, and that was eaten by that person who was given to us. So we felt really regretted, you know. We feel like eating that sweet, but then we have refused it, so we were not able to enjoy that sweet. So when our alumni president called me up and he told me to come and speak something about it, I said, okay. And I said, for what purpose, why you are approaching me? He said, you please come and entertain me. So I'm trying my best to entertain you all. I hope you guys are getting entertained. See, entertainment side, there are so many past days, the school days that we have spent, the days that we spent in the school. If I keep on speaking, the whole day is not enough. There are so many stories to be said. There are so many stories to be told. But one thing I'm really careful for the school is that the school has really motivated us in leadership quality. The school has really motivated us to do away with the shyness. Because of the school today, I'm standing here without any shyness and I'm facing all of you, thousands of you, and I'm really grateful for that. Without the school's motivation, I would not be standing here today and speaking it out. And plus, the friends, because of the school has made us bring us together. You know, this morning while we were going up to receive our chief guest, my colleague Dr. Easter, we were discussing that, you know, even though we are staying in Nagaland, we hardly meet each other. But the school days was the only days that we were together. You know, we used to argue a lot, we used to fight a lot. On top of that, we used to have fun also. And those days, we didn't have any hard feelings also, even though we argue with each other, even we fight with each other. And that is really glorious. And we wish, how I wish today also that all my batchmates, all my classmates are together and we hang out together. How I wish that to happen today also. But life goes on, we go further ahead and ahead. And this school has, you know, achieved a lot. In our days, the school has produced, we had the best basketball team. We represented Nagaland in sports also. And moreover, in football, in the field of football, one of our classmates, Manan, he went to Salt Lake Stadium, Calcutta, representing Nagaland. We had so many people representing Nagaland, and we have our Olem Chongla, who was our classmate till class 8. He even topped in our, from our batch, she even topped in class 10. And in our civil service exam also, she topped it. I also has to catch her, so I also, in the next match, I also followed her. So that is the, you know, facilities that the school has given us, and we are really happy with the school, because without this school, we wouldn't be what we are today. I think I'm taking much time, because, but last night, me and Lydia, we have argued that I have asked our alumni president to give us 15 minutes. I'll take 10 minutes and 12 minutes, and Lydia to take 3 minutes. But Lydia said 3 minutes is too less, so I added 2 minutes extra to her, so she'll be speaking, taking 5 minutes, and I'll be taking 10 minutes. Because the program committee informed us that it's only 5 minutes. But anyway, we won't get an opportunity to again speak out our past. So please don't mind for me taking such a long time. Last but not the least, in this Jubilee celebration, let us all, to the youngsters, you know, your teachers will be very strict to you. You know, you will feel that they are pushing you too hard, but it is done because they love you and they want you to achieve in life. And that is exactly what has happened to me. I'm speaking in my practical, you know, experiences. You might be not liking what the teachers are telling you, but kindly cooperate, kindly be attentive in class, and you know, if you do that, you will really achieve your goal. And with this Jubilee, let us all try to, as the motto says, nurturing leaders for a better tomorrow. So let us focus on it, and let us, you know, bring the good things that has happened in the past, so that we take it to the future to make it more future, more excellent, and above all, let us all become a good human being. Thank you so much for giving me opportunity. Love you all. God bless. Christ King, long live Christ King Higher Secondary School.
A very good morning to everyone. I am deeply honored and humbled to be standing here today on this momentous occasion, celebrating the Golden Jubilee of my school. Standing here, it takes me back to the first day I stepped into the school. In fact, the boarding as a class 2 student. And I went on to spend the most formative years of my school here. This school was my first window in my entire journey of learning. I also remember with innocence of childhood and adolescence, my school days. It was filled with so much fun, laughter, and mischief. You know, every phase of our life, as we go, we hold memories. Some are happy and some not so. But when I look back, my school memories, the happy days outweighs the sad days. That was how I spent my days here. I also remember with gratitude in my heart the fathers, sisters, and teachers who were behind us, molding and shaping us with great values, not just academic, but how to face life. Things like how to be compassionate, how to be disciplined, how to be confident, to have integrity, and above all, to find joy in the small things of life. Thank you, my dear teachers, far and near. Like my friend Winnie mentioned, it will be so incomplete for me if I don't mention Father P.K. Matthew, because he was the principal almost all throughout my stay here in this school. And he was an inspiration to me, and I'm sure to many of us here today. You know, he was never harsh, and he never used the stick to teach us, to discipline us. I remember as a kid, we would disobey the school rules and he would call us to his office. We'll be scared and like anxious as to what would happen. We would go in, but you know, he would reprimand us for our wrongdoings in such a way that by the time we left the office room, we have smiles in our face and in fact even sweets in our hand. That was Father P.K. Matthew. The relationship with Father P.K. Matthew was more of a parent than a principal. Because when I was a kid, and I'm sure many of my friends, during the lunch break, we would go to his office room and ask for 2 rupees. And many a times he would give us a rupee or so. But at times, he would call us to the parish to share his lunch. That was Father P.K. Matthew. And today, Father P.K. Matthew, due to ill health, he's unable to be with us, but it is our prayer that God will bless him abundantly. And Miss Zita, who is actively still serving in this school, she was the one who introduced us to music, singing at a very early age. And it is only now, as I grow older, I realize that it is so enriching. Music is so enriching for the mind, body, and soul. Thank you, Miss. And as for my friends, you know, as we go about life, we make many friends. But childhood friends, school friends, they always hold a special, they always remain very dear to our hearts. And I'm so glad to see many of you here today. I would also like to take this moment and thank the Alumni Association, the president, Mr. Avo, my friend, and the officials who have worked relentlessly day in and day out, leaving aside their personal engagements on all our behalf, the alumni who are scattered all over, and for contributing to making this Jubilee a success. Thank you, dear friends. Today, I stand here with so much pride in my heart, seeing my school achieve such stature. And I, on behalf of the alumni, extend our warm wishes to the school. You know, the journey of our school is an ongoing process, and we look forward to the future with much positivity. This school, it has gone on to produce so many wonderful individuals, and it is our prayer that it continues to do so. Last but not the least, may the glories of our school, Christ King Higher Secondary, never cease. Thank you so much.
It's always great to reminisce about good memories of our past. It keeps us humble just to know exactly where we came from and all the hard work we had put in to be here. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Mr. Wendy Konya, Project Director, Rural Development, and Mrs. Lydia Yapcho, Advocate. Thank you, sir and ma'am. Kreiskin family is very proud to announce the successful achievements of our teacher awardees, as well as HSLC Topper awardees. And to do the honor, I request our guest of honor, Right Reverend Dr. James Topil, DD, Bishop of Kohima Diocese, to kindly come forward and give out the awards. As I call out your name, kindly come forward and receive the award from the Bishop. In the first place, we have the teacher awardees. First, we have Ms. Zeniki Nyozita. In 1996, Ms. Zeniki Nyozita has been awarded National Award for Teachers Award Teachers by the Government of India in recognition of her valuable services to the community as a teacher of outstanding merit. Second, we have Mr. Koijam Jitendra Singh. In 2017, Mr. Koijam Jitendra Singh was awarded the State Award for Teachers for his keen interest in the subjects that he is teaching. And in the past 4 years, four of his students have stood in the toppers list of HSLC examination in the Nagaland state. Third, we have Mr. Lohead David. On 5th September 2018, Mr. Lohead David, an assistant teacher of the school, was given the district award by the Department of School Education, Nagaland, for his outstanding service and valuable contribution to the community as a teacher. Now we shall have the HSLC Topper Awardees. First, we have Mr. Kevijalia Belho. In 1998, Mr. Kevijalia Belho got the 9th rank in the HSLC examination conducted by the NBSC. Second, we have Mr. Zavad Domhe. In 2012, Mr. Zavad Domhe got the 5th rank in the HSLC examination in Nagaland State. Mr. Zavad Domhe. Next, we have Ms. Vilabinyo Kire. In 2013, Ms. Vilabinyo Kire got the 44th rank declared by the Nagaland Board of School Education. Ms. Vilabinyo Kire. Next we have Ms. Kesobinyo. In 2014, Ms. Kesobinyo got the 25th rank in the HSLC examination in the Nagaland State. Ms. Kesobinyo. Next, we have Mr. Sholu Movi. In 2014, Mr. Sholu Movi got the 28th rank in the HSLC examination in Nagaland State. Mr. Sholu Movi.
Thank you, dear Bishop, for giving away the special awards to the awardees. The next person to come on the stage is a man who hardly need any introduction. He is a person who have made all of us proud of his distinguished work in numerous capacities. I am now profusely elated to take an opportunity to invite our special guest, Sri Tamjan Imna along, Honorable Minister, Higher and Technical Education and Tribal Affairs, Government of Nagaland, on the stage to bestow on us his words. Sir, you may kindly take your time.
First of all, I really thank Almighty God for giving me this great opportunity, the privilege to be able to be part of a celebration, a jubilee of Christ King Higher Secondary School. Most respected, most reverend Bishop of Kohima, Father James Topil, the Vice Provincial of the Don Bosco Province, sisters, fathers, the principal of Christ King Higher Secondary School, Kohima, the teachers, both teaching and non-teaching staff, the village council chairman and the council members of PKL, all the alumni of Christ King Higher Secondary School, the distinguished parents and people who are present here, and my dear students of Christ King Higher Secondary School. First of all, words are not enough to congratulate all of you on this momentous occasion. Two even think about a jubilee is such a momentous moment. To understand 50 years of an educational institution like Christ King, I know it has been a very, very long journey. I am still not 50. I am going to be 40 only. So for me to have my jubilee, I need to have a lot more years to put into. So 50 years is a long year, and it's called a golden jubilee because it is truly a milestone for any institution or for any person to be part of it. The mesmerizing songs by the Jubilee Choir, the young boys and girls, were so beautiful. I was looking at you all, and the smile that went in your faces really brought jubilation to my heart. I did not know that this program would be such a beautiful program where I would be participating. Many a times, I have a lot of words to say, but today, I am almost wordless and speechless. The fathers, the principals, the teachers that have made this day, through the 50 years of your service, many a times, you may feel that the society is ungrateful. Many a times, you may not be acknowledged for what you have done through those 50 years. But I tell you the truth. The people of Nagaland, the students that have passed out through this school, will ever be grateful to you. The society will ever be grateful to you, even if they may not come up front and say it by their words. Nagaland, a state that is going through a tremendous change during these times, especially, and the merit of having an educated state, one of the most educated states in this country, and the merit of having to go through all these changes with boldness is because of what you have done. Because of what you have taught. When the alumni, both of them were speaking, I was also remembering in my heart my days in Don Bosco School, Dimapur. Today is not a Don Bosco day, so I give the credit to Christ King. So I will not speak much about Don Bosco days. But I am glad that this school is managed by the Salesians of Don Bosco. They are anointed to do this work. My dear friends, my dear teachers, fathers, I was just sitting there and thinking about those fathers and those sisters who dedicate their lives far away from their homes, far away from their comforts, far away and keeping far away their ones and looking after the needs of the Naga people. Kudos to all of you. My respects and salutations to all of you. For the achievements of your life may end in nothing. No wealth, no vehicles to possess, no buildings to stay at your retirement, no good watches and no beautiful woman to be with you, but, or even for the sisters, no handsome man to take care. But I tell you, you have earned your merit, and God and His kingdom knows that for sure. Without your sacrifices, without your countenance of consistency and persistently giving up your own dreams and making the dreams of others be fulfilled is a godly endeavor. Men on earth, women on earth, want to achieve for oneself beyond one's dreams and expectations. But it is rare to see men and women, young men and women coming in and giving up dear ones to live for the needs of others. And so today, I, on behalf as the minister of this government and also as a young man and a citizen of this state, thank you with all of my heart to all the fathers and the sisters who have sacrificed numerous days, numerous hours, numerous lives in this state of Nagaland to make us so eligible for everything for tomorrow's merit. And also the teachers, my dear teachers, I do know when our alumni speak about you all. You are the most wonderful and beautiful people that we ever come across. I know, respect in heart, we Nagas are still a little bit slow to show it practically. But I assure you, in the days to come, our people will know that, because teachers are those people who makes all the difference in the lives of people. I pray that one day our state's achievement of taking the teacher's post to the least, to the last category of any profession will change for young men and women who are studying, who are meritorious, will one day choose to take the post of a teacher much more than any other post, because it is the job of a teacher that is truly satisfying. The imprint of a mother and a father is much. I need not say here much about it, but my heart will not be satisfied if I do not say these things today morning. And the imprint of parents are always there, but the greater imprints are the imprints of the teachers in the life of the students. My dear teachers, I want you to know that your job is a terribly serious, tremendously wonderful job. You may not know that some of your students are falling in love with you, all of you. You may not know that your students are admiring you. You may not know that they are respecting you so much that they take you much more higher than the peers of their society. So, do lean your hearts towards my brothers and sisters who are in your hands. Mold them, shape them, break them, and build them to be the able and capable people of Naga society, who shall be fearless to truth, and they will speak the truth, work hard, and be fearless towards nepotism, hypocrisy, and lies. Build our people to be strong, to be at the forefront of the nations, and to build a robust Naga society. Christ King Higher Secondary School has come a long way in that. And I know this institution of repute in Nagaland has done its job in a mighty way. My dear friends, who all that are listening and who all that are here today, I want to let you all know that in the transition time of the Naga people today, We need to be able to speak out the truth. We need to be able to be bold and fearless and not be afraid of the threats of guns and bullets and to die. To die is to be a great human being, and to die very humbly and proudly is most important. My dear friends, if we keep our mouth shut and mum during these times, then we are going to be cowards. I know many of you who are sitting here are capable and influential people of the society. Parents are most influential in their families. You may be youth leaders, you may be officers, you may be practically anyone. Through this time, why have we landed our Nagaland in such a kind of a situation? It is because of the spirit of fear that has overtaken the Naga people. Fear of telling the truth, because hypocrisy has taken its toll on our lives. Fear of telling, we are not afraid of your guns. We are most afraid that our people are more weak. Teachers and students and citizens alike, we need to be humble before God and men, and yet be bold to speak the truth. I always say, it is enough that our people stop gossiping. It is enough that our people need to stop being heroes and heroines of propaganda and lies. And social media heroes and heroines are not what we want among the youngsters, but people who are resurgent to build a strong Nagaland, not only for today, but for tomorrow. How can we do that? Is what all of you need to think. My dear students who are here, 50 years have gone by for Christ King. As you start your journey from today onwards, on the 51st year of Christ King Higher Secondary School, I want every and each young man and woman to think very boldly and be self-reliant and be responsible people who are not afraid to say, yes, I have done a mistake. Yes, I am wrong in this. Yes, I want to change Nagaland. I want to change my home. I want to change my streets. I want to change the lives of the peoples of others who need change much more than I do, is what we want to pull you in your hearts in Divya. If you want to change only yourself, if you want to bring wealth only to yourself, if you want to build only for yourself, then the future of our people are bleak. No one is going to take our wealth, our earnings, to any kingdom other than our mere life that we are going to live on this earth, as long as it is the will of God. Only in that life we will live. A people without vision is dead. The Naga people need a vision. And any person without a goal is completely distracted. Today, we are talking about a Naga society that is robust, strong. But it can only be a society that is robust and strong if we work towards it, not if we dream towards it, not if we sing songs about it, not if we daydream about it. We can make it strong and robust if we work selflessly, fearlessly, and boldly towards its goal. Like I always say, when you play football, it doesn't matter what brand of cloth you are wearing, Adidas or Nike or Armani. It doesn't matter how handsome you are or how beautiful you look. It doesn't matter there what perfume you have worn. The only thing that matters is whether you can score the goal or not. And once you scored a goal, you will smell beautiful even if you may stink. You will look handsome even if you are ugly. And whatever you wear will look the best on you. We want young men and women of Nagaland who will score goals for the future of Nagaland. We want young men and women of Nagaland who are bold enough to take every negligence into one stride and build that to be the strength of our people. We want young men and women of Nagaland that are conscious about its environment, that are conscious about its families, that are conscious about its indigenous heritage and values that we have inherited from our forefathers. No amount of fashion of the Western world, no amount of prosperity, no amount of constructions and buildings and development should take away the indigenous heritage and our beliefs and our rights. My dear friends, today I don't want to bore you much with my speech to all of you into your hearts. But I want to tell you that we all have a common dream. A common dream where we have to work towards it. I want the young men and the women to listen to what I have said very carefully. If you are afraid and conscious only of your style and fashion and your makeup and your mobile phones and not conscious about your environment around that is getting dirty, that is getting wasted, that is getting deforested, that is completely going at chaos, then the beauty that you wear will not be enough to cover the loss of beauty of our state. If you are not willing to work hard and want jobs without going for interviews, without writing your exams, and just forming unions and unions, then we will not have a robust officials and bureaucracy. You will expect the same for your children and the children to come. Because you have got a job without interview, because you got a job without giving exams, you will expect the same for your children. My dear friends, let us be bold for what is right. Let us not be bold for corruption. Let us not be bold for hypocrisy. If your elders are speaking hypocritical languages in meetings and in programs, humbly tell them, Uncle, Auntie, Papa, Mama, this is not the way it's going to work today. The way it's going to work today is hard work, is by speaking the truth, is by not being rhetoric, but by being historic, by doing the right thing at the right time. We want everything for ourselves clean. We want for everything for ourselves promoted. We want everything for ourselves in the most best and robust manner, but we don't want so for the rest of the people. That is not the society, that is not the leaders we want for today and tomorrow. Today, on this 50th anniversary of Jubilee of Christ King Higher Secondary School, I encourage each and every one of you that are here to make sure, especially the parents and the elders, to mold your children prayerfully. It is not by the size of the community. It is not by the size of our population. But it is by molding strong people for a strong future. God has loved the Naga people thus far. We are like the Israelites. We could have been forgotten, forsaken, but yet, with prayers of a few, God has lifted us up thus far. we should never forget the Almighty's grace upon the Naga people. But we should not be like the Israelites that kept on grumbling and grumbling and grumbling, accusing each other, pulling each other down. Their journey got longer and longer and longer. And the generation that grumbled, the generation that forsook the living God, the generation that forgot the mercies of God, never reached the promised land. We, the younger generation, will reach the promised land. We, the younger generation of Nagas, will reach that land where our people will be prosperous, where our people will live without fear and prejudices and hypocrisy under God, and build a robust society that will not only be developed and be a blessing to the Naga people, but will also be a blessing to the rest of the country and will be a blessing to the rest of the world. One day, Naga doctors, engineers, teachers, fathers, sisters, and all kinds of professionals will impregnate the society of the nations and build Nagaland and the Nagas into a robust, sovereign, strong people. I would like to conclude my speech by saying thus far. Thank you so much, Father Principal of Christ King, for inviting me. What more is a joy for a young man to be able to shell out its heart towards its people, and especially towards young men and women that are sitting here so robustly. One day, when we will all be no more, these young men and women will build Nagaland very robustly. I thank you all for all your endeavors, especially the Christ King community, the church, and the school, the higher secondary school, the fathers, the sisters, the teachers, both teaching and non-teaching staff, and the students for making such a profound influence into the society of Kohima in particular, and to all. I thank the landowners of Kohima Pikel. I heard that the landowners are always very kechara, but I have come to know that the Kohima landowners Pikel are very, very robust and visionary people. 1968-9, you have given your land for such a wonderful society, for such a great institution. I tell you the truth, you have your reward, even if you have not got anything in cash or kind. I know you may sometimes be regretting construction kuribuli bi dhyanai, commission bi dhyanai, father khan nasi ku dibunwaribo. Will be Abuni Khan Bura Diabura Naga Manulaka Society Bunai Sede, Uncle Khan, Baba Khan. And I, on behalf, am thankful to all of you. Honorable Deputy Chief Minister Sri Y. Patton, Minister for Home and R&B, who is also a Catholic, I came to know that just a few months ago. He has also given his greetings and best wishes to the Christ King Church and to the school, higher secondary teachers, and also to you, Most Reverend Father Bishop. His greetings, due to some very unavoidable circumstances, he had to leave for Delhi immediately, and I had to come here. So he has given his best wishes and his greetings to this great jubilee. Thank you all. God bless all of you. God bless the Christ King Higher Secondary School. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir, for devoting your precious time and endowing us with your words of wisdom, experience, and encouragement. We shall now entertain ourselves with the enthralling performance from our little ones, Fusion of Colors by Primary Section of Christ King Higher Secondary School.
significance of colors. Colors is the characteristic of human visual perception. This perception of colors derives from the stimulation of cone cells in the human eye by electromagnetic radiation in the visible spectrum. Colors not only attract our eyes, but signifies different feelings. Colors influence your choices and changes your feelings. Here, we bring to you significance of colors. Gold. The color of gold is the color of success, achievement, and triumph. Signifies abundance and prosperity, luxury and quality, prestige and sophistication, value and elegance, linked to energy and the power of the sun. Purple, the color of reality, wealth, and success, dresses the mind in luxury and provokes elitist thoughts. Purple signifies cooperation and togetherness. White, the color of purity, innocence, and emptiness, often used as a symbol of peace and spaciousness. It is clean, hygienic, and sterile. Red. Red evokes strong emotions, patience, or intensity. The color red signifies love. Blue. The color most preferred by men. It signifies calmness or serenity associated with water and peace. Pink, the color of calm and warming color. It signifies love, femininity, and womanhood.
Ever lies before, and ever just as sure.
50 years is a major milestone for an institution as it is for an individual. Our celebration is not much as festivity but a solemn occasion to pause and look back at the 50 years journey. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru's words aptly fit the occasion. We never measure time by number of years, but what one feels and what one has achieved. It is now my great pleasure to invite our guest of honor, Right Reverend Dr. James Topil DD, Bishop of Kohima Diocese, on the stage to share the Jubilee message.
Most respected special guest, Sri Temjan Imna Long, Honorable Minister, Higher and Technical Education and Tribal Affairs, Government of Nagaland, Right Reverend Father Nazarius Lakra, SDB, the Vice Provincial of Dimapur Province, Reverend Father Linus, the Principal, Reverend Father Paul, the Rector and the Parish Priest, Reverend Sister Joy, the Provincial, and her sisters, the village chairman and the council members, dear fathers, sisters, members of the managing board, esteemed staff members, alumni association members, parents, students, past and present, invited guests and my dear friends. First of all, let me in the name of the Diocese of Kohima and the Catholic Church in Nagaland and the Commission for Education, Diocese of Kohima, wish and congratulate Christ King Higher Secondary School, Kohima, on the occasion of its Golden Jubilee. I am very happy that Christ King Higher Secondary School has grown from a tiny seed to a mighty tree spreading its branches around. 50 years in the life of an institution is very significant. Every race begins with a single step, a step if taken rightly leads an institution for greater glory and success for generations to come. The Christ King School has taken this rightful step, benefiting hundreds of students and people around us. As you know, it began in 1969 by the personal initiative of some of the good and visionary leaders of Kohima Village under the leadership of Father Resto and the commitment of the Church and the Salvation Society has brought light and life to many people, not only in Kohima district, but the whole state and outside. During the last 50 years, many have gone through the portals of the school, taking the rightful place in the society. And therefore, it is a time to rejoice and to acknowledge the many people, the management, the staff, and the faculty members, students and parents, and well-wishers who have journeyed along these past years to give shape to what the school is today. We cannot but salute in gratitude the pioneers, especially the members of the Salvation Society and all their collaborators, particularly the Bethany sisters, who despite opposition and deprivation, toiled and labored without counting the cost for the development of the institution and its peoples and for the progress of our people, even at the cost of threats and intimidation of various types from different quarters. The journey has not been very easy, and yet it has been very fruitful and rewarding. Thank you, dear fathers, sisters, leaders, and well-wishers. I also thank and greet the staff, past and present, the student, past and present, who have contributed much for the growth of this institution. As you know, the Church is well aware that education is the key to development and progress. The All India Catholic Education Policy, formed in 2007 and which is being revised now, has given a specific direction to Catholic educational institutions. Accordingly, education by its very nature is transformative, namely changing human persons and through them, society and its structures. Education is not merely to prepare one to earn a living, but to prepare one for life. Education must serve as the gateway to the social, cultural, and economic development of persons and of the country, fostering pluralism, cultural and religious diversity, individual and collective freedom, and respect for and appreciation for differences in the face of a globalized world that aggressively pushes towards economic and cultural uniformity. Education must help the people to grow as men and women of character, competence, conscience, compassion and commitment, who will then contribute to the evolution of a counterculture to the presently ruthless competitive model by promoting collaboration and cooperation for the growth of all in a climate of mutual trust and sharing, and to a shockingly corrupt society by fostering uprightness in public life. In this sense, the students of Christ King School, the past and present and the future, must be its own brand ambassadors and proponents of the values which they have been taught while passing through its doors. More than mere academic education, it is the integral and holistic education that attracts both parents and students to the school. The Church's intense and extensive apostolate of education continues Jesus' mission of liberation and of imparting fullness of life. It emphasizes a holistic and fuller development that meets the challenges of modern culture and society and its demand for a higher level of competence. Therefore, the Catholic education institutions are basically service-centered. They are not profit-oriented corporate houses where profit is a priority. It gives preferential option for the poor and the marginalized. The Church, through its education institutions, strive to build a new society built on justice, peace, love and harmony. We want all citizens to become literate, skilled and competent, socially conscious and spiritually motivated, and fully involved in the building of a developed and just society. Thus, education does not become an end in itself. Rather, it must empower one to live well and be happy. It must make people not merely to do the right thing, but enjoy the right thing. Not merely to be industrious, but to love industry. Not merely to learn, but to love knowledge. Not merely to be pure, but to love purity. Not merely to be just, but to hunger and thirst for justice. Not merely for a living, but for life. As the school steps into diamond years, I wish and pray that Christ King School may attain greater heights of glory in the years to come. Once again, I wish the management and the school the very best for the Golden Jubilee celebrations and implore God's choicest blessing. Thank you and God bless you.
Being creatures of compassion, we express our emotions through various actions. Coming before us is stomping on the Bible verse Psalm 100 from Don Bosco Higher Secondary School, Kohima.
Next, we have a message on behalf of Dimapur Province. I request Reverend Father Nazareth Lakra, SDB,
Vice Provincial Salishan Province of Dimapur to come up on the podium and give a message to the Christ King family.
Dear Sri Temjen Imna Along, Honorable Minister, Higher and Technical Education and Tribal Affairs, Government of Nagaland, Right Reverend Dr. James Thopil, Bishop of Kohima, Sister Joy Provincial, Bethany Sisters, Sister Sandhya, Vice Provincial, Bethany Sisters, Father Lonwo Linus, the present principal of Christ King School, Kohima, Parish Priest Father Paul Pene, past principals, the past pupils, and present students. Today I stand here in the name of Reverend Father Jose Kuruvichira, the provincial of Salishan Province of Dimapur, and all the Salishans of the province, to congratulate you and thank you for the amazing work that has been done in all these past 50 years and the wonderful work that is being done today, here and now. The school was started by Father Resto SDB in 1969 and was looked after by the Bethany Sisters. After some time, the administration was taken over by Father Itiachan, and some of the fathers have seen him here itself. Over the years, the school has grown in number and structure. Principals came and went, building the lives of students. Students came here and studied and passed out of the school, leaving legacy of hard work and excellence. Now past pupils have grown in number, and many of them are occupying high offices in the state and in the country. Many of you have seen a tiny plant of Christ King School, which has grown into a mighty tree of educational institution as Christ King Higher Secondary School. Today, with the psalmist, I would say, I will give thanks to you, Lord, with all my heart. I will tell of all your wonderful deeds. I will be glad and rejoice in you. I will sing the praise of your name, O Most High. Psalm 9, verses 1 and 2. Today, we thank God for his constant blessings. God has truly blessed us in every way. We congratulate past principals and teachers for their dedicated service they have rendered to this institution. I congratulate and thank Father Lonwo Linus and the teachers and other staff members for the wonderful organization that has gone ahead to make this day a reality. I congratulate Father Paul Pene, head and leader of the institution, who has been coordinating all the works and activities of this institution. I congratulate all the past peoples who have brought name and fame to this school. Today, we thank them for their tireless work and contribution to this beautiful celebration. The present students too have worked hard to make this celebration a successful one. This is my prayer for you all. God bless the school. God bless the staff and the students. May all of you be united and work together for the greater success and the glory of the institution. May God bless you all.
We are grateful to you, dear Father, for conveying your message to us. Let me now invite Sister M. Joy, Provincial Superior, Bethany Sisters, to deliver your message to us on this auspicious occasion.
Good afternoon to one and all of you present here. Sri Temjin Imna Along, Honorable Minister, Higher and Technical Education and Tribal Affairs, Government of Nagaland, Right Reverend Bishop James Thopil, Bishop of Kohima, Reverend Father Nazarius Lakra, SDB, Vice Provincial of Dimapur Province, Father Paul, Rector, Father Linus, Principal, Sister Melissa, the Vice Principal, Bethany sisters, especially those who are working here at present, fathers, sisters, brothers, alumni of Christ King School, staff members, students, parents, and all of you, friends in the Lord. It is with pride that I stand here before this large August assembly on the occasion of the Golden Jubilee of Christ King Higher Secondary School, Kohima, 1969 to 2019. I am proud because Bethany congregation has been an integral part of the story of 50 years of Christ King School, Kohima. Bethany sisters arrived here in 1969, that is at the inception of the school, from faraway Mangalore. Mangalore is right down south of India, the west coast, and sisters coming from there to here. Just one aspect if we take, the climate. In the south, in Mangalore, we never used a shawl, even in December, January. That was the cold of Mangalore. And sisters who came over here had to be in this cold winter throughout the year, and then imagine in December, January, February. And the sisters coming from all the way down south adjusted to these conditions and collaborated with the Don Bosco Salesian fathers in the pastoral work in the parish and in the school. Christ King School was born and grew up with the Bethany sisters. I think it won't be an exaggeration if I say that the first few batches of students grew up practically on the lap of Bethany sisters, especially in their boardings. Such was the love and care with which the past students remember our sisters. I congratulate the Salesian fathers, the students of the past and present, and my own Bethany sisters on this golden occasion. So warmest felicitations to one and all. I'm particularly joyful because 2019 also marks the arrival of the Bethany sisters in Kohima. The records say that the very first class of the school was entrusted to the Bethany sisters in 1969, and one of their convent rooms was their classroom. Sisters continue their unstinted service to this day in close collaboration with the Don Bosco fathers. I have great admiration for Don Bosco fathers for their missionary spirit and for the people of Kohima parish in particular for their generous faith response that was given to the missionaries, maybe the fathers and sisters. And this parish has blossomed well and is bearing abundant fruit. And today we heard some of the old students of the school for their testimony as to how they have grown in this school. And you can also see the progress when you glance around here. I'm sure the first students of the school here may not be recognizing this place at all. It would be so different from 1969 to this 2019. And this Christ King School has been the bedrock of foundation for intellectual and spiritual growth. Isn't that marvelous? The Christ King School has taken giant strides since 1969. Now, the parents and grandparents of the school are sending their children and grandchildren to this school. Christ King School has truly become a landmark. It has stood firmly the onslaught of arrival of other educational institutions of modern digital age and many other challenges of the new age era. I take this opportunity to express my gratitude to all, to each and every one of you who has been instrumental in raising the level, the standard of this school from class 1 to class 12. Those of you, especially who have been supportive of Bethany Sisters in the past and in the present. No doubt, there have been plenty of challenges, even frustrations, yet fullness of life must rest on such challenges and pruning. And God has blessed the Christ King Higher Secondary School, and God has blessed all of us who have been in some way or the other associated with the school and with the mission here. I wish all the students, teachers, fathers, sisters, and along with the people of Christ King, God's choicest blessings. May it be truly a golden jubilee today and a diamond in the future, in the days to come. Thank you, and God bless all of us.
We are really obliged to you for endowing us with your wisdom. Thank you, sister. We are almost coming to the end of the grand golden jubilee celebration, but nevertheless, to gratify us before we depart, we have a special number from Christ King Alumni Association.
For the things you have done for me, things so undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love for me. The voices of million angels could not express my gratitude, all that I am and never hope to be. I owe it all to you. Let there be pleasing, Lord, on
Good things come to an end. In ordinary life, we hardly realize that we receive a great deal more than we give, and that it is only with gratitude that life becomes rich. I would now like to invite Father Lonio Linus, Principal Christkind Higher Secondary School, on the stage to propose the vote of thanks.
I will give thanks to you, to the Lord, with my whole heart. I will tell of your wonderful deeds, says the psalmist in Psalm 9:1. Dear honorable special guests, guests of honor, dignitaries, past principals, headmasters, headmistresses of CKHS, fathers and sisters from different institutions, special invitees from different associations of Kohima Village, Christ the King Church Kohima Village, and Christkind Parish Kohima, heads of institution from different schools, alumni members, media fraternity, parents, well-wishers, staff and students of CKHS Kohima. I stand here with the same sentiment of the psalmist to propose the vote of thanks on behalf of the management, staff and students of CKHS Kohima. In the first place, we thank God Almighty for blessing us with pleasant weather and for His manifold blessings over the past 50 years. God has been so good and gracious to the institution, and He will continue to do so in the years to come. We would like to say a big thank you to our honorable special guest, Sri Timjim Imna Along, Honorable Minister, Higher and Technical Education and Tribal Affairs, Government of Nagaland, for having accepted our invitation to be our special guest. Sir, we thank and appreciate you for your youthful and dynamic presence in our midst as a special guest and also as a Bosconian. We are so inspired by your message, and I believe all of us present here on this special occasion will take it to heart. A word of sincere thanks to our beloved Bishop, His Lordship Most Reverend Dr. James Thopil, D.D. Bishop of Kohima Diocese, for his fatherly presence on this special occasion as one of our guests of honor. Thank you, Your Lordship, for always having a soft corner for Christkind High Secondary School. We also would like to express our sincere thanks to Reverend Father Nazarus Lakra, SDB, Vice Provincial Salesian Province of Dimapur, who represents Don Bosco in our midst, for having accepted our invitation to be one of our guests of honor. Thank you, Father, for bringing the blessings of Don Bosco and the Salesian congregation by your presence. Our sincere thanks to Sister Joy, Provincial Bethany Sister, Northeast Province, for her valuable presence on this special occasion. Past rectors, principals, headmasters, and headmistresses of CKHSS Kohima had contributed their might in making what CKHSS is today. Therefore, we thank each one of them, though some have left this world and some are not present here today, for all the hard work they put in order to raise up CKHSS to greater heights. dear fathers and sisters from different institutions, thank you for accepting our invitation to be part of our Jubilee celebration. Our sincere thanks to all the dignitaries, special invitees from different associations of Kohima Village, Christ the King Church Kohima Village, Christ King Parish Kohima, for your valuable presence on this special occasion. We would like to thank all the heads of institutions from far and near for your extreme presence on this occasion as well. Though words alone will not suffice to express our thanks, but we would like to place on record our deepest sentiments of gratitude to the alumni executive members and the alumni association of Christ King High Secondary School under the able leadership of Mr. Nilhunolia Adrian Michillo for their unstinted support and cooperation right from the start. A special word of thanks to all the conveners of various alumni jubilee committees and members who willingly sacrificed their time and energy for the success of our celebration. We are simply overwhelmed by your generous contribution, love and appreciation for your alma mater. A note of sincere thanks to the people of Kohima Village and Kohima Village Youth Organization, especially the QRT, for your assistance and also for your valuable contributions in making our Jubilee a great success. Our appreciation goes to the Electricity Department and PKL Students Union Kohima Village, who braved the inclement weather and put up all the lights in the hall and the surrounding. We cannot but say a big thanks to Tefokokroto and Catholic Women Association of Christ the King Church Kohima Village for taking up the task of preparing the delicious Jubilee feast for all of us right after this program. May God continue to bless you all. We also express our sincere thanks to the 4th NAP Battalion Tizama for setting up the sound system and also for accepting our invitation to entertain us in the evening with their music. We live in the world of mediadom today, and hence we thank the media fraternity for the wonderful job of covering up all the sequences of our celebration today. We are so glad to have all our parents and well-wishers, and we thank them for their valuable presence and cooperation. A very special note of thanks to all those who composed, lyricized, and conducted the Jubilee Choir beautifully. Last but not the least, on a personal note, let me avail this opportunity to express my sincerest appreciation to the staff and students of Christ King High Secondary School Kohima, who gave their best effort to make this day memorable. Though we would like to thank each and every individual who contributed in many different ways, but in order to save time, let me cut short my word of thanks here. I am sorry if I have left out any individual to thank, although not intentionally. Thank you and God bless. Long live Christ King High Secondary School, Kohima.
Thank you, Father, for tossing the word of thanks. We have come to the end of the program, but this is just another beginning. We will need your support and blessings so that our school can keep disseminating the light of learning and knowledge as it has come doing. Finally, to mark the end of this glorious event, we will all stand up and sing with pride the school anthem. So I request all of you to stand up as to intone the school anthem.
Peace and love and serving.
thank you all for being a part of our celebration. We invite each and every one of you present here to partake in the great Jubilee Feast.